This is the Jupiter Inlet, a fun place to get into the ocean. The reason that we want to talk to you is that it can be dangerous.
Hello, I'm Paul Drucker, North District Supervisor for the Palm Beach County Beach Patrol. We're bringing you this presentation on running the Jupiter Inlet to caution everyone on the hazards of a stormy day, large swells, and wind chop.
The boat is 31 feet and under the control of Bud Gladwin, a former commissioner and chairman of the Jupiter Inlet District. He probably knows as much or more about how to run or how to handle this inlet as anybody else in the area.
We're approaching the inlet, as you can see. The waves are breaking fairly far out, so it looks like if we cut hard right around the south jetty, we should have a fairly easy passage. As we turn, however, you will roll quite a bit on this flying bridge, so be prepared to hold on. Now, if you look to the left side, that would be extremely bad in a small boat today. You'll notice your waves are breaking all sorts of directions. See what rolls in? Some of the waves, even with the current going out, the waves are coming into the inlet. And we are going to rock quite a bit here in just a few minutes. Be prepared to have one hand for yourself. The old saying, with any ship, one for the ship and one for yourself.
Things to consider as you're headed out the inlet would be the shape of your hull, the size of your boat, your speed, size of your engines, your passengers on board, are they secure? Your equipment, do you have PFDs, is everyone wearing them? Do you have flares available? Do you have an anchor and line available in case you lose power? Consider all these things. As you get out the mouth of the inlet, stop, wait, watch for a while, time the lulls, time the sets, check your depth gauge. As you head out through the surf and the swells, the best idea is to go perpendicular. Head straight into the waves, and this way you will not lose steerage from one side or the other. Hold on tight to your wheel and move slowly through the waves. You don't want to go too fast and become airborne and lose control. You don't want to stop at the face of a wave and possibly be thrown back. Move slowly through the waves and you'll be safe. Some boaters look for the channels that may be available. They check where there's white water, and they consider that low spots. They check where there is no white water, and they realize they have more depth there. They keep an eye out for shallow areas that may be lighter in color, and they avoid those areas. Many boaters have gone to the south to escape the swells, or they run through the sets of swells, being careful not to be caught from the side by a wave. Many people, also not familiar with navigating swells, are apt to run into problems. Make sure that you have experience in doing this before you attempt it. Be as safe as you can for yourself and for your passengers at all times.
Long flat.
Once outside, you need to come back in at some point. Number one again is be prepared. Use caution and take your time. Sit and watch from outside for a while. Conditions may have changed quite a bit through the day. It depends on tides, currents, wind, weather. Take your time. Time the lulls. Time the sets. Look for the channels. Pick your time and place. And go ahead. It is once again best to stay perpendicular to the waves. If you're caught in between two waves, it's best to move up on the back of a wave and stay there and follow it all the way in. Do not move through the wave, or you could possibly fall down the face of it and broach. Do not go too slow that the wave behind you catches up to you, floods your engines, and you lose power. Again, stay perpendicular. If you go at an angle, you're apt to be slapped from the side by a wave. Some boaters have found there's a channel to the south, and they come in that way. And although they are not perpendicular to the waves, they are running through the same trough of two waves, and they stay in that trough. County lifeguards are on duty every day at Jupiter Inlet. They monitor a VHF radio and will be in touch with you if you need assistance. We also have an Avon rescue boat, which we keep on hand, and we will be able to get out to you within minutes. We contact the Coast Guard for any problem that we may have. We also contact fire rescue.
I have a little more power when I come in than when I go out, so that I can move it if I have to. Now, in other words, if I should see, again, one rogue wave that does happen occasionally, I like to be ready for it. So that while I'm watching the inlet, I'm also watching outside the inlet. And it'll keep you busy. It'll keep you busy in here. See the waves again coming way in, and you just take your time, ease it on in here. A little bit more power. We've got quite a current, so you have to give it just a little more power, and you just take your time coming in. All the people are quite enthralled watching some crazy person go out the inlet in this weather.
It's important for all of you to realize that the Jupiter Inlet is not approved for navigation on any of your navigation charts. However, it is utilized by about 50,000 boat movements a year. Local knowledge, understanding, education, a realization of the hazards and the joys of utilizing the inlet are extremely important. I hope, on behalf of the Jupiter Inlet District Commission, that this program tonight will help all of you better utilize the inlet, the access to the ocean, and your pleasure and enjoyment of the beautiful area we have in the Jupiter to Cuesta area. Thank you very much.